Hello friends. In the last videos, we had seen the simple and weighted options of Pareto chart in both Microsoft Excel and Minitab. In this video, we will see the third option, that is, Pareto chart by variable in Minitab with the help of practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. So, let's begin. Pareto chart by variable. A Pareto chart by variable is used to identify the group with the most frequent defects, the most common causes of defects, the most frequent causes of customer complaints, or the most contributing elements in any of the problems. In this option of the Pareto chart, there will be subcharts explaining the major contributors in each of these groups. This Pareto chart helps us to focus our improvement efforts on the group and major contributors where the largest gains can be made. Let's understand this with the help of example. Example of Pareto chart with a by variable. A quality engineer for an automotive supply company wants to decrease the number of car door panels that are rejected because of paint flaws. The engineer wants to determine whether a relationship exists between the type of paint flaws and the shift during which the door panels are made. The engineer enters the name of each defect into a worksheet column called flaws and the corresponding shift into a column called shift. Then, he creates a Pareto chart by variable to prioritize the groups and defects to be addressed first, based on the frequency of the defects. Create a Pareto chart by variable in Minitab. To create a Pareto chart, please follow the steps. 1. Copy or enter the data into the Minitab worksheet. 2. Select Stat, Quality Tools, and then Pareto Chart. 3. In Defects or Attribute Data in Enter Flaws. 4. In By Variable in Enter Shift. 5. Select Default Option with All on One Graph, Same Ordering of Bars. 6. Select Combine Remaining Defects into One Category after this percent and enter 95. This is the default value to combine remaining defects in the Others category. We can change it to any valid percentage and also can select an option of Do Not Combine if required. 7. In Options, we can enter the label for X-axis, Y-axis, and the title for the Pareto chart. 8. Click OK to get the results. We will get a Pareto chart by variable for all shifts with the same ordering of defects. Interpretation of results. In this example, the chart shows that most of the flaws are from peels and scratches, and the night shift produces the most flaws overall. The engineer should investigate why these defects are most common during the night shift. This is all about a Pareto chart by variable and its detailed illustration with the help of practical example in Minitab. We will see the next important topic with a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful. Add your valuable comments, share this video with your friend and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such videos from our channel, please do not forget to subscribe to it. Click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.